morning students, our today's practical is use of CRO. Let us see what is CRO. CRO is cathode ray oscilloscope. Cathode ray oscilloscope is used to display different waveforms in electronic circuit. Basically, it is a testing device. It is used to check the waveforms at different points in electronic circuit. Using CRO, we can measure the VPP, time period and frequency of any waveform. VPP means peak to peak voltage. Using CRO, we can measure peak to peak voltage of any waveform. Okay, now there are two types of CRO. One is dual trace CRO and another is single stage CRO. The difference between single stage and dual trace is that using single stage, we can study only one waveform at a time, and using dual trace CRO, we can study two different waveforms at a time. Means, for example, rectifier circuit, the input of rectifier circuit, what is rectifier? Rectifier is a circuit which converts AC into DC. The input of rectifier circuit is sine wave, and suppose it is half-wave rectifier, the output is half-rectified output. Then we can study these two waveforms at a time on your screen. This is the main advantage of your CRO. Now let us see what is the requirement of instrument today for today's practical. We require function generator, dual trace CRO and CRO probes. There are two types of CRO probes. One is two-side connector CRO probe and another is one-side connector and another side is crocodile pins. It depends on which type of function generator you use. Now for today's function generator, we require two-side connector CRO probes. Now first connect the CRO. This is the CRO probe to connect to AC. Means switch on the AC mains switch. Then this is your power switch. Now this LED indicates that CRO is on. When CRO is on, you see one horizontal line on your screen. Now adjust this line on the scale line axis, means it is on x axis. Suppose, for example, your screen is blank, then is it CRO? You say that CRO is not working or it is faulty CRO. But when you adjust the knob, intensity knob, you see the screen, one line on the screen. Suppose if intensity is okay, then also your screen is blank. Then adjust the vertical knob, you see the one line on the x axis. Now your CRO is ready to take the readings. Now see the basic knobs which are used to adjust the CRO. This is your time per division knob. For dual trace CRO, there is one time per division knob and 2 volt per division knob. Time per division knob is common for Y channel and X channel. Suppose you want to study only one waveform, and suppose your output of your circuit is connected to Y channel, then use only Y channel knobs and don't use X channel knob, because these are connected to only X channels and our requirement is only Y channel knobs. Use only Y channel knobs. Okay, this is your level and variable knobs. These knobs are used to adjust the to stable the waveforms. If your waveform is not steady, you are not able to take the readings. So first requirement is stable the waveform using variable and level knobs. Time per division knob is used to adjust the waveform on x axis, means you adjust the time period or frequency. Volt per division knob is used to adjust the voltage on y axis, means VPP. Now requirement of today, for today's practical we required function generator, dual trace CRO and CRO probes. Now this is your function generator. Function generator is a device which has, using function generator we can adjust the different waveforms, for example sine wave, square wave, triangular wave or DC also. The capacity of this function generator is 0 to 30 volt AC. We can adjust the frequency also. Frequency from 1 hertz to 1 megahertz. This is the maximum capacity of this function generator. Now connect the output of your function generator to Y channel of CRO. For that we require two side connector probe. Before that we connect the function generator to AC mains. Now switch on the AC mains, switch on the power supply, on off switch which is push button switch. Suppose you want to change the frequency, now it is on 1K, 10K, 1000K, 1 mega. Suppose for today's practical we adjust the waveform on 10K. 10K is not constant, this is your display of your function generator. Now V, that's V indicates the voltage, and there is small unit V, that V indicates this is the voltage, and you can adjust the voltage using amplitude knob. Okay, now adjust the frequency. Now again press this switch, then now it indicates 5.05 and unit is kilohertz. Now frequency is 5 kilohertz. Okay, then adjust the frequency using this knob, means you can adjust the frequency from 0 to 1k because your switch is on 10k. So using this knob you can adjust the frequency from 0 to 10k. Suppose your knob is on 100k, then you can adjust the waveform frequency from 7.5 hertz to 100 kilohertz. Now set your frequency on 10k range and now connect the output of your function generator to the Y channel of CRO. Now you see the waveform on the screen, but this type of waveform we are not able to measure the voltage, time period or frequency, so adjust the waveform. Using intensity we can adjust, increase the intensity of your signal. Using focus we can sharp the signal. Still we are not able to see the waveform properly. Then adjust the volt per division knob. Now it is clear sine wave on your screen. Our aim is to find the amplitude, time period and frequency of this waveform. For first, what is time period? Suppose this is the screen of your CRO. This is Y, Y dash, X, X dash, just like graph. And this is the origin of your graph scale. Adjust the waveform such that the starting point of your waveform is at the origin and like this. If there is another waveform, no problem. Our aim is to measure the complete one waveform, time period for complete one waveform. What do you mean by one waveform? Half positive and half negative makes complete one waveform. This is the time period for the waveform. Now adjust the waveform using horizontal lamp knob, right? This is your starting point. Sharp the waveform for accurate reading. Okay. Now this is the scale line of your CRO. The least count of CRO is 0.2. Very, very important thing is that the least count of CRO is
0.2. The screen has main scale line on x and y axis and dark lines on x axis and y axis. Okay, there are small lines on your main scale line. This one small line is equal to 0.2. Now the measure the distance for complete waveform on x axis. Now it is one dark line, 1, 2, 1, 2, and small three lines, means the distance is equal to 2 plus 3 small lines, means 0.6, means total distance on your y axis is 2.6. Now for time period formula is equal, formula for time period is distance on y axis for complete one waveform into time per division knob. Now your time per division knob is on 0.2. 0.1 means 2.6 multiplied by 0.1, and unit is millisecond. Look here, there are three units: second, millisecond and microsecond. Your knob is on 0.1 and the unit is millisecond. So it is on 0.1 millisecond. So it is 0.6 millisecond, calculated 2.6 into 10 raised to minus 3 second. What is the formula for frequency? 1 upon T, so 1000 divided by 2.6, whatever it is in hertz. This is the time period in second and frequency in hertz. Now measure the VPP, means peak to peak voltage. CRO displays peak to peak voltage and DMM indicates, using DMM we measure the RMS voltage. This is the main difference between measuring voltage of DMM and CRO. CRO, suppose press XY mode both signal, adjust, you see one straight line parallel to Y axis on your screen. Now using horizontal knob and vertical knob, adjust the waveform on scale line and divide it into half. On positive y axis you see one dark line and small two lines, means 1.4, and same on below, one dark line and small two lines, means total distance is 2.4. Now this is the time period, this is the voltage VPP is equal to, now release the XY mode, VPP is equal to distance on Y axis, it is 2.4 multiplied by volt per division knob. This is your volt per division knob. Now it is on 20 volt. Unity, there are also two units, volt per division and millivolt per division. Now your black line of your knob is on 20 and unit is volt, so it is on 20 volt. Whatever it is the VPP of your sine wave. Thus, using CRO, we can measure VPP, time period and frequency of your signal. And also CRO is used to test the waveforms at different points in your electronic circuit. Now, using function generator, we can change the amplitude. Now, I can vary the this knob, which is amplitude, and see the difference on your screen. We can measure on y axis, so there is difference only on y axis. Amplitude changes, but frequency and time period is same. Okay, when you change the frequency, you see the change on y axis like this. There is variations only on x axis, not on y axis. Means you change the time period or frequency of the signal. You can change the waveforms also. This is your sine wave. Using function generator, we can change the waveforms also. Now it is triangular waveform, square waveform, and DC. DC line means it is parallel to y-axis. When your DC line is above your scale line, then it is positive voltage. Suppose your DC line is below scale line, then it is negative voltage. Thus, we can find the DC voltage also using CRO. These are the main applications and uses of your CRO. Thank you very much.